I thank the Lord that I'm back.
Amen.
This is my second home.
Amen.
Okay. But thank the Lord that my missionary journey in Israel was very successful.
Praise God.
Okay. And since you are the one in charge of all our international work, I think you deserve to hear some reports, no, from Israel. First, we were able to organize them as a fellowship already. And there were about 12 who signed the covenant. And so that, as directed by your senior pastor, so that their church anniversary then will be on the second Friday of November. And that's a good time for the celebration in Israel, because as far as tickets are concerned, ay mas mababa po in November. So if ever you plan to go in celebration of their anniversary on the second Friday of November next year, you reserve your tickets now. Okay. And then, of course, the situation in Israel is different from the situation you have here in Dubai. I think almost 98% of our Filipinos who are working in Israel are all caregivers. And so, ang problema po nila ay during Fridays, unless their boss, no, would allow them to go out, okay, hindi sila pwedeng umalis. Okay? So that they're going to church during Fridays in Israel would depend totally on the decision of the boss. However, kung hindi sila naman lalabas po, to their advantage, in a sense, no? Dahil may bayad yung extra day nila. Pero to their advantage financially, pero spiritually po, I think they are losing something big, no? So let's pray for Israel. I had the opportunity to talk to one Jew. And I was surprised when I was in the airport. I was surprised that I was expecting that one of the members of our group would pick me up from the airport. But when I saw the one who was picking me up, he was a Jew. And he was so gracious enough, you know, to take me from the airport, take me home. And ang ginawa ko naman sa kanya po is I invited him to attend the anniversary the following Friday. And he did. And he was there, no? And I was trying to, you know, I was thinking of something that the Bible mentions about the Jews, no? Although totally, according to not actually totally, but according to the Apostle Paul in Romans chapter 9, that as far as the nation is concerned, Israel is now being rejected. Okay? However, if you move on to chapter 10, in spite of the fact that as a nation they are now being rejected because of the rejection, sa chapter 9 naman, Paul is saying that there is an election of grace among the Jews today. And I said, who knows that yung mga bosses ng ating mga caregivers ay yun ang mga elected ones, no? So our people have the a rare opportunity to not only minister, not only to help them physically, but also to minister to them spiritually. So let's all pray that the Lord will bless the work. Of course, yung mga at the very outset ng work po ay sabi natin very not very impressive, no? One good thing is they have their own flat already. They're paying 6,000 anong pangalan ng pera, no? Shekels, no? A month. And however, we thank the Lord that the church is now sponsoring Dikabayan tours. So that if you ever plan to tour Israel, then maybe Dikabayan tours will bring us to the places where we want to go, no? And the proceeds of that Kabayan tours support the church.
Amen.
So, mayroong kunting ano sila, sideline in order to support the work of the Lord. Okay, and so let's continue to pray that the Lord will bless the work. We are in a special nation as far as God is concerned. Kasi sabi ng Bible po ay Israel is truly the chosen people of God. I had the opportunity also to witness to a Jew in the Wailing Wall, no? And he said to me, I believe in the Torah, but not the New Testament. He said, all religions related to Christ are all bullshit. Sabi ko sa isip ko, the Bible is true. That as far as Israel is concerned, by this time, they are rejecting the Messiah. And that's the reason why they have been rejected by God. However, let's pray that the Lord will lead us to people that the Lord has already included in the election of grace. So that we'll have that opportunity to minister to these people. Okay? Okay, I don't know if you realize, beloved, that at this very moment in America, there is something special that is going on now. Now, it's Thursday night in America, no? And America is now celebrating one of the Baptist heritage. And that is the celebration of Thanksgiving. If you trace the origin of this, it all started in 1601 when the Pilgrims, or another name for them during that time, the Puritans, and they are the forerunners of our Baptist group in the United States, by leaving England, because they were persecuted in England, they landed in Massachusetts, and the first thing that they did was to celebrate Thanksgiving. Okay? And later on, the presidents of the United States, several of them made some decrees that America should celebrate Thanksgiving as a celebration. So, Thanksgiving in America is a big celebration, bigger than the celebration of Christmas. Totoo po yun. At kawawa ang mga turkeys ngayon sa Amerika. So that if you think of this celebration as far as America is concerned, beloved, it has a glorious background. Okay? And I wish I have that opportunity at this time to go back backward in the history of America to mention about the background of this special celebration they are now having in the U.S. Okay, but as far as Faith Fundamental Baptist Church is concerned, we are also celebrating our Thanksgiving celebration. And this is also very special to us. And as far as our church is concerned, it also has a very glorious background. That's why we are celebrating. I think when I was the senior pastor since 1996, when we started celebrating Thanksgiving in our church, I don't know if since I'm now retired, I don't know kung ipinagpatuloy nila this. Supposed to be po, the celebration at FFBC will be last Sunday, Sunday before Thursday of America. Okay? But why do we celebrate as a church our Thanksgiving? It has also, beloved, a very, very special background. Okay? It all started in 1996 when we were trying to open our high school department in the Antipolo Faith Christian School. No? When it was during that time when I decided, after during graduation time in March of 1996, I decided to open the high school department by faith. But in the Philippines, you cannot just simply open a private school without a permit. So, as far as getting the permit during that time is concerned, po, it was already too late to apply for the permit. Since, if you want to operate a Christian school in June, you have to apply in August, prior to the coming of June, so that by May, you will have the permit. But during that time, I applied in March, knowing that the Lord will work it out for us. But when I went to the department, the first question that they raised, I said, Pastor, what is your facility? And the thing that I showed them was a picture of the building. And the head of the department told me, sabi niya, Pastor, we do not believe in picture here. Okay? We want you to have first the facilities, then you may apply for a permit. But I told them, I extended a challenge to them, sabi ko sa kanila, Sir, you just give me a temporary permit. And by God's grace and by faith, we will provide the facilities. So, it was made during the time, and you know, in the Philippines, because of the corruption, no? My application went from one table to another until it came to the assistant chief of the secondary in Region 4. And he saw my name, okay? And when he saw my name, applying for the permit, he remembered, sabi niya, I think I know this pastor, Pastor El Pao, whom I met 20 years ago in Mindoro. I was invited to speak in Mindoro. And he was, during that time, the principal of one of the schools in Mindoro. So he called me up. And I said, yes, I am the pastor. I went to Mindoro, and I personally know you. And you know what he said? Pastor sabi niya, don't worry about your permit. I'm putting my neck on this. Wow. I will sign the permit.
Praise God.
Okay. And that was something really, very special. However, he said, you need to provide the facilities. I said, yes, we'll do that by faith. So we opened in November, in June. Then after a few months, the department would visit us again sometime in November to see to it that we are complying with the requirements. But during that time, we did not have the money to start the project. Although, ready na po lahat. I got the building permit, and okay, just waiting for God to provide. Because I know during that time that that Ed would come to visit us. So that during the first second Sunday of November, I told the church, sabi ko sana, if we truly believe that God is able to provide, I told them, let's do the groundbreaking ceremony this coming Sunday. So we did the ceremony without the money. Okay? And then Monday came. And then dumating po yung Friday, and a very strong typhoon hit Antipolo. And at the height of the typhoon, during that time, somebody called me up over the phone and sabi niya, "Pastor, I thought it was an emergency because of the storm." But on the other end of the telephone, he said, "Pastor, congratulations. I thought," sabi ko, "it's an emergency. But this is something unique," I said, "because during this stormy time, someone is trying to congratulate me over the telephone." And he said, "Congratulations, Pastor. Somebody heard about your project and he's giving 2 million pesos. Wow. Okay? And you know what? That was Saturday. That was Friday. So the following day, Saturday, I went around all the members and told them, I said, "Let's all celebrate tomorrow. Let's all bring fruits to church." Okay? Because the Lord answered our prayers.
Amen.
And so, pagdating po ng Sunday, punok ng fruits. Yeah. That's why during celebration, every year that as we celebrate Thanksgiving, we always offer fruits as an emblem of our gratitude to the Lord. I hope they will continue that even after my retirement. Okay? And you know what happened? The following day, Monday, we started to dig the foundation. Okay? And by Friday, DepEd came. And I told them, "See, I'm starting the project." And you know what, beloved? God was never too late.
Amen.
That's why we have, every time we have the celebration at the church on the second, the Sunday before the celebration of America, this is something big as far as our concern, our church is concerned. Okay? So, ang problema lang sa America ngayon po ay they have the form of the celebration, but they do not have the substance. Parang ano lang, it's a holiday, so let's celebrate. But yung substance of the celebration has already been lost along the way. But you know, beloved, whenever we think of Thanksgiving, it is not simply the heritage of America, but it is the heritage of all believers in Christ. What I'm saying is, we should also celebrate Thanksgiving, and Thanksgiving should not only be confined during the day of the celebration, but according to the Bible, it should be a lifestyle on our part. Okay? And then in the spirit of the celebration, I want to call your attention to a particular passage recorded in Luke chapter 17. You know, whenever you think of Thanksgiving, the original word in Greek came from a combination of two words. One word is grace, and another word is joy. So that Thanksgiving is a word, then, that is expressed in gratitude with joy to the God Almighty for bestowing upon us the many good things in life, in our lives. That is Thanksgiving. And this morning, we want to look into a particular incident recorded in Luke chapter 17. I think you are very familiar with this this record, and it has to do with the healing of the 10 lepers. Okay, and if you look at verse 11, beginning from verse 11, no? You see the background of it. Now it happened as Jesus went to Jerusalem, so that by this time Jesus was already on his way to Jerusalem, few days before he died. Okay, before we went to Israel, all we thought that all the events recorded in the Gospels all happened in a very in a locality that's just simply very small. Na parang si Jesus was just simply roaming around doing ministry. But that's not actually the case. Okay? If you travel from North Galilee, no, going to South Judea, Jerusalem particularly, and Bethlehem, it would take us now, driving 110 or 120 kilometers per hour would take you 5 hours. Okay, how much more if you think that Jesus just simply walked, okay, doing good things around. So that ang ginawa ni Jesus dito is this: as he traveled and would fulfill his mission to Jerusalem by dying, he left Galilee, Nazareth, and in every village that he would pass by, he would stop for a while, do some special ministries there. So one village to another village, and probably it took him a lot of time to do that, traveling from Galilee to Jerusalem. At this time, he was now traveling to that, and he passed by a village. And according to the record, in that certain village, there were how many lepers? 10 lepers who were crying out very loud for help, for healing. And Jesus took his time to extend his healing power to them. Okay? Now, when you consider a narrative in a sermon or in a message, we must always consider either the character involved. There is always the character involved. There is always the plot, parang short story and plot. And there is always the climax. And normally, it is in the climax of the narrative or story where you can extract the message. Okay? So let us not concentrate as we get into this passage. We will not take time to consider all things involved, but I want us to consider particularly the climax of the story. And the climax, you find it in verse 17, particularly in verse 17, no? Where you find the question of the Lord after seeing one of the 10 who came back to say thank you for the healing. Okay? And when he saw that person, and he was a Samaritan, according to the record, God simply asked a very striking question. And what is that question you find in 17? He said, were there not 10 cleansed, but where are the 9? Very striking question, right? We want to revolve around that particular question as we think of Thanksgiving during the celebration this week. Okay? And there are a few things that I would like us to think about in relation to the question that Jesus wanted to drive to us today. Okay? Where are the nine? Asan po yung siyam? And first of all, I want us to think of it as a question of disappointment on the part of Jesus. If you get into the very heart of the question in the light of the context, there is a deep-rooted disappointment in the heart of Jesus when he asked the question, where are the nine? Okay? And you know what, beloved? It is in this question that one of the greatest failures of the human heart and the human nature is involved in that question. At alam niyo po ba kung ano yon? When he said, where are the nine? Okay, why is it that there is only one who came back to say thank you to me? Well, it's a problem of ingratitude. And according to the Apostle Paul in Romans chapter 1, verse 21, this is actually one of the problems of our hearts, not only during that time, but even during this time. The irony is, beloved, sometimes it's not the unbelievers who are guilty, but it's us believers. Because in the context, according to Jesus, he was surprised that the one who came back was a Samaritan, not the Jews. He was expecting na sana Jews ang ano. And according to the Apostle Paul in 2 Timothy chapter 3, that the magnitude of the sin will reach its highest proportion in the last days, when men will be, ano yun, nakalagay, will be ungrateful. And if you look at the ratio in our text, there were 10 who were given the blessings of healing. But out of the 10, only one came back. So that anong proportion nila then? It's 10% only. At as I said, ang irony dito po ay yung bumalik ay yung unbeliever. Well, beloved, what a disappointment on the part of God whenever we who are recipients of the blessings of the Almighty would miss to come back and say thank you, Lord, for all the blessings. Maraming ulit po, this is our problem today. Actually, beloved, one of the signs of ingratitude for the blessings the Lord has given to us is your lack of giving. I don't know if you realize that giving your tithes is a token, is an emblem of your gratitude to God. And I think a lot of believers are really guilty of this. We want all the blessings, but we miss to express our hearts in gratitude for the blessing. So that the question that the Lord raised to the one who came back was actually a question of disappointment. And I believe that during our time, God is also very disappointed with us. Someone has said that mayroong kwento po na there are always two baskets that are being brought up to the throne of God. One basket is the request, and another basket is thanksgiving. Itong basket of request ay parating mo. Every now and then, basket would come up before the throne of God, okay, requesting for something, some blessings. But the one, the box of thanksgiving, seldom would go up and bring the praises and thanksgiving to the Almighty God. Well, this is actually, beloved, a generation of ingratitude, even among us believers. You find this in a lot of areas in our lives. You find ingratitude on the part of children to their parents. And it's very disappointing, amen? Kung kayong magulang at ano, it's very disappointing after you have done all the good. And alam nyo, you will not realize how your parents, how our parents did a lot for us, not until we become parents. Look at Joey. Diba? Ah, talaga naman yan. Well, kung maari, hindi pwedeng padapuan niya ng langaw o ano. No? Okay. But, ang problema natin po is paglaki niyan. Diba? And you find this in a Christian home. Children are not grateful. You also find this in the church, right? Yeah. Oh, ano bang sabi ko nung ano? Nung nakaraan dito? Pastors have double honor. Okay. And the offering them double honor is actually a token of gratitude to them. And there is so much conflict in our churches today. Conflict regarding the pastor. Someone has said that yung pastor daw ay parat marami ulit after the worship time. Pagdating sa bahay ay ulam siya. And you'll find this anywhere. And I personally believe that as Jesus was disappointed when he did not find the nine, but only one. So he raised the question, where are the nine? Okay? Beloved, if we fail in this, it's on the part of our God, it's very, very disappointing. Okay, secondly, because I'm only given 45 minutes, I'm just beginning. Okay, not only question of disappointment, but it is also a question of demand. Look at verse 18 again. And you know what Jesus was saying here? If you get into the very mind of Christ when he raised this particular question, he was simply telling the one seeking for the nine. At ang sabi ni Jesus sa kanya, where are the nine? They should have also returned to me as you return to give me thanks. They should also. So he asked the question, where are the nine? He was demanding for expression of gratitude on the part of the nine. Okay? So that it's a demand on the part of God other words, what Jesus was saying to the one who came back, sabi niya, this should be the right and the only right and the only logical thing for them to do as you did it. Now. So he said, where are the nine? Well, beloved, I think if we look into the Bible, this is also a demand from God to us. Now, Acts chapter 17, look at Acts chapter 17, verse 28 particularly. Because I believe that what the Apostle Paul said in this verse constitutes the very foundation of our gratitude to God. And in the context of Acts chapter 17, when the Apostle Paul was trying to introduce to the Athenians their unknown God, he mentioned about this God to them. And let's look into that particular verse, Acts chapter 17, sapagkat maganda po ito, tingnan natin. That constitutes the demand why we should. There's only one logical thing we should do. Because according to the Apostle Paul, verse 28, sabi po niya dito, for in him, look at the him there in the capital letter, no? Of course, in the context, it's God. Okay? He said, for in him we live and move and have our being, as also some of your own poets have said, for we are his offspring. Now there are a few things that are very important for us to realize in the verse. Okay? Sabi niya, by him, or in him, or by him. Okay? And originally, this by him expresses that it is only because of God. It's only by God himself. And there is no other word, beloved, to express totally our dependence on God. It's by him. And then he said, we move, meaning we derive our strength. Apart from God, we are nothing. Okay? In him we move, he said. And look at the last part of the verse. Anong sabi sa last part? Our being is mentioned there. And these are words, beloved, that would express emphatically our utang sa Panginoon. At utang na loob, magpasalamat naman tayo. Amen?
Amen.
Marami tayong utang. Utang na loob. Salamat naman tayo. Right? And we should realize this. And the nine lepers failed in this. In this particular demand ng Panginoon. But let's look how it all started with the one. Mm-hmm. If go back to again, to Luke chapter 17, how it started on the part of the one who came back to give praise, to give thanks, glory to God, to whom he received all the special blessing. And according to the record, look at verse 14, how it all started. So when he saw, verse 15, and one of them, when he saw that he was healed. Okay? Now look at the beginning of his life of gratitude to the one who offered him the special blessing. Okay? Sabi niya, when he saw that he was healed. In other words, until we see, beloved, until we realize that our being is totally dependent on God's grace and mercy and blessing, we will never, never go back to Him to express gratitude. And this is a very, very important thing for us. According to Psalms 100, you know the verse, no? You know the passage, Psalms 100. Know ye that He is God. Know ye that He is good. That's the beginning. Unless we come to the point that we know that the God, that our God Almighty has given us all the blessings in life, we will never go back to Him and express our gratitude. But He deserves it. Amen?
Amen.
That's the only thing logical for us to do. That's why when he asked that question, where are the nine? He was actually demanding that the nine should come back also. And not only the one. Okay, back. Then finally, it's another thing is it's a question of desire. Review natin po. First question of what? Disappointment. Second question of demand. Now, we can also see in the question a question of desire on the part of Jesus. You know what? When Jesus saw the one who came back, Jesus cherished the gesture of this one man. And how he wished, that the nine would also have that opportunity, like the one who came back. Diba? Kasi alam nyo kung bakit po, there is always that joy on the part of God and joy on our part. Whenever we receive blessings, special blessings from Him, that we go back to God in worship, expressing our gratitude. And as far as God is concerned po, ay tuwang-tuwa siya noon. And it's also on our part. When we do that, okay, we also experience what? The joy. Okay? Because, sabi natin po, ay thanksgiving is a combination of two words, grace and joy. If you picture the one who came back, how would you picture him during this time? Well, previous to this, according to the record, he was one of the ten who cried out to the Lord while he was passing afar off, malayo. Because these people were lepers. And on account of that, I outcast sila ito. They had been isolated. That's why they were housed in a certain village. And intentionally, Christ passed by that village. And I think we have the same thing we have. Noong unang panahon po ay yung leprosy ay kinakadirian. Okay? And in Palawan, you have a colony. Di ba? Anong lugar yun? Palawan. Kulyon, Palawan. One time we went there. And one of the instructions given to us, because we have to present to them the gospel, I brought along with me the gospel team to do the singing, and then I did the preaching. But the instruction was never shake hands with the lepers. Kaya ang problema po, lahat ng tao doon makita mo, mga putol, mga... Okay, and so we came up to the platform, Matasyon platform. Problema po ay, nung bumaba na kami, ay nag-extend ng ano, ng kamay yung ano, kasi gesture na yun, ha? So we had no choice, but to hold his hand. Okay. To find out na yung kamay niya pala, putol na. Because of leprosy. So, isolated ito. So that when Jesus passed by, afar off, according to the record, they were crying loud for help. But look at what happened after this. Because in verse 15 po, and verse 16, he was no longer afar off. But according to verse 16, this man, makita niya siya na already fell down on the face, on his face at the feet of Jesus. So near. Sabi ng awit, what a fellowship, what a joy divine, leaning on the everlasting arms. You have that song in the hymn, huh? What a fellowship, what a joy divine, leaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness, what a peace is mine, leaning on the everlasting arms. Now he is so near, so close, in fellowship with the Lord. Well, question of desire, and Jesus was trying to say to the one, he said, how I wish the nine would also experience the same as you now experience with me. Someone has said that the problem with us, beloved, we are so loud in crying out for help, but so low in offering gratitude. Yan ang problema. Someone has said that idolatry begins in the heart when gratitude to the giver is replaced by greediness for the gift. Maganda yung paalala sa ating ngayon, it's better to give than to receive. And the tendency for us, beloved, that when we are so blessed that we forget the giver and we are overwhelmed with the gift. And that's idolatry in one sense. Okay? Well, let us begin to not only cry out loud in for help. Kung wala kayong trabaho, normally what? Lord, help. I'm about to leave. I don't have work anymore. In the Philippines, whenever believers are looking for work, they would come to the pastor. Also help me, pray for my work, pray. So, the normal thing we do is we pray for that person to provide the work. Problema po, pagka na-provide na yung work, di mo na siya makikita sa church. So loud in crying for help. Low expression gratitude. Well, may the Lord help us that we learn to give thanks to God. Not only during time, during times of celebration of Thanksgiving, but should be every day of our life.
Amen.
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 Because there is joy in this particular day. Masaya po yun, masaya. Hindi lamang tumanggap ka ng ano, blessing, hindi lamang tumanggap ka ng ano, masaya yun, pero mas masaya kung bumalik ka sa Diyos. Magpasalamat.
Amen.
Totoo yun. And Jesus wished that the nine would have experienced the same thing. Father, we thank you for your word, reminding us, rebuking us, of the many failures that we have many times experienced in our lives. Forgive us, Lord, for this wrong, and help us to be always in gratitude for all the blessings you have bestowed on us.